Hey Podders, this is episode 187 of CosPod Podcast for all things cosplay. Welcome everybody. So happy to have you here with us. If this is your first time, welcome. We're very happy that you're here, and I apologize in advance because you're about to see one of the most zany things on the internet. For those of you who've been with us a while, yes. Thank you for sticking with us.
That person is Amber. I'm Valerie, by the way.
And of course, happy middle of convention season.
Good gravy. I think they keep popping up with more and more cons every weekend because Cosplay in America always adds more every time. And I'm just looking at this list like, where did these come from? There's literally like 500 cons a weekend at this rate.
And not only are there conventions, but there are special events that they don't bill as conventions, but can still be multiple days long. And they still basically end up being a convention.
Pretty much. Something for nerdy people to do nerdy things.
Uh-huh.
I was okay with that.
We're running out of money like halfway through the year.
Yeah. I can't spend that money because I've got vacation. So that needs to be compartmentalized and pushed over there.
It's like, oh, there's this really cool thing I want to go to, but I just finished a convention and yeah. Sorry, guys.
Bills! It's part of that adulting thing. Yeah. Woo!
Plus, there's always that perpetual, hey, I need to purchase more materials for cosplay.
And even though I try so hard to get things on sale, like, it still seems like I'm hitting, like, that $200, $300, $400, $500 mark. I'm just like, it wasn't supposed to get more expensive the more coupons I use. How did the reverse happen?
I'm sure cosplayers understand. You walk into Joanne's with a list, you walk out with more than what was on the list.
I try really hard to stick to that list unless I absolutely need something, like if I have to get refills on glue sticks, or if I need to get one of those craft foam rolls, because, you know, craft foam rolls, you can use craft foam for everything.
They don't even sell the rolls anymore.
They don't. You have to get them online. Amazon does have them, though.
Yes. I'm still sad that I can't just walk into my local craft store and get them anymore.
Darby, right.
You made a mistake.
That sucks, but I'm sure there was a good reason behind it. It's probably sales or something.
I'm sure. It's just still mildly annoying to have to get it shipped when it's like, I can just go 2 miles down the road and then come back and immediately work on my cosplay. Maybe it's just I'm being that privileged millennial and that I just want to be able to sit down and work on it right now.
The immediate satisfaction of doing it.
It's so rare when I want to do that, but sometimes it's just, I was only missing one piece of my cosplay and I need to.
Yeah, the latest piece that I'm working on, and hey, we'll transition into cosplay updates because of this. Hey! Segue, go me. The latest piece that I'm working on, a portion of the fabric I had to get online because it was a specific type of spandex and then a specific type of scuba fabric. I'm working with scuba fabric, but it's Yaya Han scuba fabric, which actually it's really nice. I like it a ton. I'll probably have to talk about more of that later. So of course, they sent me the fabric and it was damaged in a really ridiculous way all along the selvage edge at the bottom. So all 3 yards of this, it was this weird brown, yellow, black, crunchy, crusty thing. And it went up anywhere from like an inch to like 8 inches up in varying degrees, but it was all along the bottom. And I was like, I can't use this. Help me, please. So they were kind enough to, they tried really hard to resolve this because I know it's not customer service fault. This is all fulfillment being fulfillment. They tried. They sent me a replacement. Similar issue with the replacement. Not as bad. It only affected about a yard of it, but it was still like this weird random brown, black, crusty thing. I don't know what it is. I've tried cleaning it. It's just a mystery and it's disgusting. So yeah, that's been my fun over the past month is trying to get my fabric ordered and in a reasonable manner and time and all that business. But as far as between the last episode and this episode, I haven't had much time to really work on cosplay stuff. So I figured this would be a good opportunity to do CosPod content, because that's really what I've been working on is CosPod stuff. Go fig. First things first is, if you guys haven't done so, we are giving away this book. It is volume 2 from the Kickstarter, and it's the Kickstarter edition. It's very, very special. Only 1,000 of these were made, as you can see sort of kind of with my weird lamp. You can't see it. Okay, it's Number 729, there you go, of 1,000.
And it's a hardback copy. It is not soft cover.
So the cool thing about this is that it's not just photographing cosplayers like the first book was. This one actually went behind the scenes, watched people craft, watched people go to Joann's and buy their fabric and supplies, but also behind the scenes of the conventions themselves. So it's a really cool book. I love my version so much. So make sure that you go to Instagram or go to our Facebook page, that you like the post and you leave a comment on it if you want to win this. And then and if you share the post, you get an additional entry. If you tag a friend, that's another entry. And if you also share it on another piece of social media, whether it's Twitter or Facebook or Instagram, blah, 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 it's another entry. We're giving you multiple chances to win this sucker. Shipping is going to be completely free. We'll take care of it on our end. Just please make sure to share, because we know our social media reach is crap because we don't pay for it.
And we want to give this away. We do not want to keep this book. We want you guys to have it.
I have a copy. I don't need a second one. I already paid for my copy. So please make sure to like, comment, share on those posts on Instagram and Facebook. We want somebody to win this sucker. And it's going to be open until the end of Friday, May 3rd. We may extend it a little bit longer if there's more interest in it, but that's going to be the cutoff time.
And also, yay, please check out Cosplay in America on social media, because Ejen is a fan-freaking-tastic guy.
We love Ejen. He's cool. He's a cool dude. So the next thing is that we finalized stuff for CCon. CCon is a convention that's taking place in the city of Carrollton, which is local to us. It's their first year. They are taking place at one of Carrollton's public libraries. And you can go to our Facebook page. We have ourselves attached to the event page, so you can actually look at the information, see what's going on. It'll be a one-day event on Saturday, June 1st. And we are going to be guests there. We'll have our own table. We are going to be presenting a panel, possibly two panels. Topics are yet to be determined. So once we know the schedule, we'll let you everybody else in on the secret. It'll be from 1 p.m. to 8 p.m. The convention will have their vendor tables from 1 to 6, and then 6 to 8 is when they're doing the cosplay stuff. And it's really cool because they're doing, it's just like a library con, so it's going to have some, you know, fantasy authors, going to have comic book artists, they're going to have some local podcasters like us, some cosplayers are going to be there. We're really looking forward to it. I've been frantically trying to make the things that will go onto our table. It has been cool stuff because it's been all the new CosPod branding, including our new business cards, which I'm so happy about. I can't wait to share those. I'm excited to see them printed.
And so, yeah. Encourage you to support your local library. So, of course, if you guys have a local geeky con at your local library, we highly encourage you to support them as well.
But yeah, that's all I got on my end. It's just me doing CosPod stuff and finalizing some things. So, yeah.
We have merch, guys.
I know. We have merch that we're giving away.
Free.
It's free merchandising. Actually, it was a little bit of pain in the butt trying to get pricing and volume and all that, but coming up with the designs, a lot of fun. The bookmarks, I'm really excited to see how those turn out because I made them very colorful, very bright. So they'll be kid and adult friendly.
Since I have not been working on CosPod stuff, I have been working a little bit on my Deedlit cosplay. And the reason I don't have a pile of fabric in front of me, as is tradition, is because I went to assemble it and then realized that I had forgotten that she has a design painted on her collar. And I didn't want to have to paint it on after I assembled everything. So I had to take everything back apart, which thankfully I hadn't gotten very far. And so I traced in the designs. And it is drying currently on my table without anything else near it. Because, of course, as we all know, what happens when you leave anything near fabric that is painted, that is drying, that Murphy's just going to go, ooh, a gift. For me.
Murphy has too much fun with that.
Yes. And everything will go splat on it because I know just if I tempt fate, fate is just going to oblige me. So yep. It is drying. And then, of course, with this particular jacquard paint, you have to heat seal it. So I'm going to have to press it, which let me just say that having a hot iron with as warm as it's been out here lately is not fun. But, you know, got to do what you got to do for cosplay. And I've actually been working on fixing up my patio outside because 'tis the season to start working on props. And of course, We always say safety first. Please do not spray paint inside enclosed spaces, which means I have to go outdoors when I want to paint things with smelly, smelly chemicals. And generally, that also means I have to take care of the wasps and things that don't like me being out there working with smelly chemicals. So basically, I've been half and half working on cosplay and then spending time prepping my outdoor space so that I can go work on the other part of my cosplay. Because I already have another cosplay that I would like to work on for summer that will be a little bit cooler, especially since we have things like SeaCon coming up, and it will be during Texas summer, where we will roast.
Yes! But so at least for that one, we'll be indoors, so we don't have to worry as much about it.
True, but we still do have to travel to get there, which means being in a hot car.
Right.
Which it's always nice to have options for cosplay and to have modular parts so that if I want to pull on a jacket or a bolero over it, but still have like a sleeveless tunic dress, much better. So that is pretty much what I have been working on. And speaking of Deedlit,
dun dun dun.
Ride that segue. So speaking of Deedlit, I wanted to give a short little presentation for you guys on Eridani's prosthetics. And Eridani Studios is, of course, a wonderful company that does not only sell prosthetics, but they also sell costume pieces. They sell jewelry. They sell nerdy knickknacks. They do sell some props, but not too many, just because anybody who has made props knows that those can be hard little suckers to ship, especially if they are of any size or just an odd shape. So, and yes, they have donated before for the cosplay contest that we do run at AllCon. And of course, we are very grateful for that. And I highly encourage people to patronize them as a company, not just because they do support us, but also because they have really good products, you guys. And I say this as somebody who purchased from them before I even started CosPod. I've been a customer of theirs. Actually, the pair of ears I'm holding are older than CosPod. CosPod is 7 years old. That tells you how long I have had these. And I have worn them.
Many, many times.
they are well loved. But the fact that these are in such really good condition, I mean, you can see there are no tears in this. The makeup shading is actually still on it. It is all still in very, very good condition after being older than 7 years. So that in and of itself should be testament. I mean, the latex does thin out after a while. But you know what? With ears this size, these are their anime-sized ears. I mean, you don't really want that much weight on these things anyway, because they're just going to flop over and you'd make a really sad night elf if this is how your ears looked, you know? So in a way, it's a good thing. But the thing I am focusing on is mostly their elf ears. And they do sell many types of prosthetic ears. They're not just the what they call manga elf ears, which is for what they call Lodoss War elves, but, you know, copyright and such. But they also sell sea elf ears. They sell what they call small elf ears, which are for Lord of the Rings elves. They sell the really, really longer than this World of Warcraft style ears for blood elves and night elves and all sorts of otherworldly creatures, I think is what they call it.
Yeah, they've got a new collection of like fawn ears, orc ears, there's gnome ears, halfling ears. They started, I think they're starting to work into horns now too, last I checked.
Yes, indeed. And they do have other facial prosthetics. So you can do Klingon pieces, I believe they have. They have some scar tissue pieces. They have all of the usual adhesives that go with them and their removers. And they also sell the specialty makeup that goes with them. Because let me tell you, when you have latex, you cannot use standard makeup on these. It actually degrades the latex. And that's not really what you want if you're going to invest money in these. You have to use specialty theater makeup made specifically for prosthetics. And they do sell all of those. And of course, you can always get them in your local theater shop as well. But with these, usually comes a small kit of two other things. You have spirit gum, which is this little, pun not intended, amber-colored liquid. This is the stuff that you usually adhere them with. This stuff is made with a derivative from tree sap. If you are allergic to tree pollen, please do not use this stuff. It will not go over well for you, and we want you to be safe and healthy whenever you are using your cosplay. So this stuff, very, very sticky. Also, tip when using this, from my own experience, if you have sideburns of hair, you may wish to shave them or slick them down with something like Vaseline very, very firmly, because if you get this stuff in your hair, it's not going to feel good afterward. You may lose the hair because you have to cut it off. Because even spirit gum remover, which is the other thing that this stuff comes with, it's a little chartreuse looking, almost lemon juicy like liquid, doesn't always get it out of your hair, and it hurts, especially when you try and pull the ears off. Unless, of course, you enjoy seeing, you know, having your neighbor see you wearing elf ears as you come back from a convention. That's cool too. You do you, whatever you want to do. Let's just say that my neighbors actually looked a little odd at me the last time I came home wearing elf ears. So,
my bad.
They were very nice.
They were.
My neighbor just kind of gave me an odd, confused head tilt and then just went about her business. I didn't ask. So, when you are wearing these, and I'm going to try and do this so that you guys can see it, and I'm probably going to regret this because my sideburns are not slicked back. So, do as I say, not as I do. When you wear these, make sure that the skin and area around your ears, if you are doing ear prosthetics, is nice and clean, because you don't want to get dirt on your latex. It does the same thing as makeup. So I'm going to one ear this. There we go. All right. When you apply spirit gum to your prosthetics, there is a front, which goes against the front of your ear, and then there is a back flap, which goes against the back of your ear. You need to apply adhesive all the way around, because otherwise it only sticks to one half of your ear and it's going to flop one direction or the other. Especially with something this size, you want maximum adhesion, because these will fall off. Mine actually did. And the other thing that you may want to make sure of is that if you need to cut a larger ear hole or slit in your latex ears, do that before you put them on. Please do not use an X-Acto knife while it is on your ear. That is asking for it. However, if you don't cut any extra slits, I've noticed with these, it's really hard to hear. I can't hear anything, including cell phones, when I have these on. So just, you know, my own experience coming your way. So I'm going to take my spirit gum. It has a little nail polish applicator there, so you can see it. Thankfully, this stuff does not smell, so you don't really have to worry about doing it in a well-ventilated space. However, you may not wish to do it near any expensive fabrics or upholstery or pets, because the pet may sniff at it and wish to try some of it. I do not recommend eating this. So I'm going to, you can see I am applying it, and I'm brushing outward. Basically, I'm doing this. You can see I am applying it. I am putting this on liberally. You don't want to skimp with your spirit gum. And I can tell where I have been because the surface of the latex is shiny. You can see the light kind of gleaming off of it. That's how I can tell that I have enough spirit gum on there. And I am doing both the front edge, which is going to touch the front of my ear, and the back edge so that it adheres all the way around. By this point, you should have taken care of your sideburns, because spirit gum does not have a very long working life. Once you put it on, you've basically got a couple of minutes to place it on your ear, which is what I'm about to do, and you have to hold it there for 30 seconds. There we go. And there's a little flap in the front that I am basically holding on. My headphone is actually just a little bit in the way. It helps if you touch this to your ear first, remove it briefly, and then tack it on again. It kind of works like epoxy in that way, honestly. I can already tell it's getting tacky. It doesn't have a long working life. And I can already tell this is not going to be fun taking it off. Generally, when you want to hold it, you hold it front and back. So it's probably going to take both of your hands to do it. It really helps to have a partner if you're going to do it this way so that they can already be working on your other side. Alternatively, they can hold it on and then you can work on the other side. And again, this is covering up my ear hole. So basically, I'm deaf in my right ear right now. I cannot hear anything out of it. Ow, ow, ow. It's actually sticking to my fingers. Ta-da! And my fingers are a little bit sticky, but you can use the spirit gun remover. You can also use acetone to remove it. You can also use hot water and a salt mixture to loosen it. I've seen a number of different household ways of removing spirit gum as well. You know, whatever works for you. If you want to use orange pumice stone, that works too, to the best of my knowledge. You may not want to use anything that's caustic just because it is your skin and you want to be safe. So basically, I would repeat this on my other side, which I'm not going to do because I need my headphones so I can talk to you guys. But this way you can see I'm not holding it on. The ear is stuck on there. I can move and shake my head. The spirit gum is fairly, you know, self-sufficient when it comes to adhesives. I don't have to do any other pinning or taping or anything else to hold it on. It holds itself on really well. And if you place it correctly, this will last you for a solid 8-hour convention. Spirit gum doesn't really wear off when you sweat, so you don't have to worry about basically you working it off. I will say that if somebody were to bump me really hard, like if I hit a door pretty hard, a doorway, then it may actually knock part of the ear off. But it takes a lot of effort, honestly. And it's very comfortable. If you have an allergy to latex, obviously, don't do this. They do sell silicone ears for that purpose. And there are other things like gelatin that you could also use as an alternative to latex. But Aridonis, these are great quality for the price. I think I paid $12 for the ears. They come pre-colored. So all I have to do is select my skin tone and they will apply the makeup for me, so that I don't have to worry about it. And they do sell additional little makeup palettes so that if you ever want to renew the makeup over time, because it can wear off a little bit, it's just a coating, then you can always purchase that. And it's also a reasonable price. And I think shipping was $5 total. So $17 for a pair of really good quality, like lasting longer than the podcast latex ears, totally worth it. The only thing I would like them to do is to cut a larger ear hole so that I can hear with this. Alternatively, it would be really neat if they offered the alternatives, because to the best of my knowledge, Aridani does not offer silicone or gelatin ears. They only offer, oh, they do. Okay. Then that is a recent change, because they didn't originally offer them when I had purchased this and my second set of ears, because I also bought my Arwen ears from them. I got the small elf version of the ears for Arwen, and you can still definitely see them. The last time I wore my Arwen ears to the Renaissance Festival, to the local Texas Renaissance Festival, I actually had a guy stop me and he was like, I swear those looked real on you. I mean, obviously he knew that they weren't, but he said that they looked real because the coloration and texture is so good. And I take that as a serious compliment to them. I mean, not to me. All I had to do was just stick it on my ear and just, you know, hope that my hair hides the seam, which that's probably the only downside to these ears, is that the seam on them, the front, especially this flap right here, is very visible if your hair is not covering it. So what you can do is you can get something called flesh latex. Aridani also sells that, and you can get it at your local theater shop. But basically what it does is you place it, and it's almost like a gel that you use to layer over the seam between the ear and your skin to hide that seam effectively. It creates just a little cover, and you know, it basically removes the same way as the ears do. And again, not good to get it in your hair. So please
you know, hair up before you put on the flesh latex. Also, one other quick thing that I know from experience, flesh latex does not last forever. Just like makeup, does not last forever. Please do not keep for 7 years, as long as the ears themselves. The chemical parts, yeah, these go bad after a period of time. Usually it's 1 or 2 years at the most. Then you can always go to, you know, your local Spirit Halloween stores or Party City or whoever has them, or your local theater shop, and get new stuff. You don't have to replace the ears, but you do have to replace the chemicals you use to apply them. Because otherwise it gets really gross and grimy, as I found out after 2 years with really cheap flesh latex, and I was not going to put that on my skin. It looked green. Was not going to match the color.
Yeah. So you mentioned gelatin ears, and we had somebody ask, what is gelatin ears?
So gelatin is from the name, gel-like substance that is very soft and flexible. It has a lot of the properties of skin, and you cast with it. I believe it's actually derived from seaweed, but you basically make a copy of your ear. So you would first have somebody make a mold of your ear, which, please do not try this at home without someone who knows what they're doing, because you can actually damage your hearing. But, you know, find someone who is trained to make an ear mold, and then you would make a mother mold of that, and then you pour gelatin in the same way you'd make a resin mold, basically. It's just a biodegradable substance so that it's safe to put on your skin, and then you can use whichever adhesive that you need to be able to apply it. There are various adhesives that work with gelatin. And the nice thing about them is that they're flexible, so they will move with you. They're not quite as stiff as the latex. The latex is actually pretty stiff compared to gelatin. So it's not quite as lifelike. They do biodegrade though, so they're not like these. They won't last you 7 years. The gelatin has a fairly short lifespan.
So yeah, some other things I want to kind of throw in there. If you are allergic to things like the spirit gum, one thing you can use is Prozade. That's a medical grade adhesive, so it's meant to be used. It's actually used for like casts. So it's really, really strong stuff. And it's the type of material that once it's on, it stays on. It don't come off until you tell it to come off. So if you were concerned about things maybe shifting or moving out of place because you have a heavy wig or you have other adornments going on, it's a good alternative. Just, you know, something to kind of keep in mind. It is very much a once it's on, it stays on. It ain't moving. But it's a great alternative if you don't have some of those allergies. Something kind of keep in mind. And then also, if you're looking for other ways to remove spirit gum and as well as Prozade, and you find that it's maybe stuck on a couple of hairs, but you think you can get it out, honestly, just use some hot water and then do coarse salt as a mixture and just gently rub it into your hair. It will come out over time. You just got to be patient with it. Give it some love. Also use some conditioner afterwards, because it does tend to make the hair a little bit extra frizzy and it can damage the end. So condition that sucker real fast afterwards. So hot water, salt, keep it simple. Remember to always get the adhesive removers, because those are your lifesavers. But it's fun stuff otherwise. A lot of fun to play with.
I totally feel like Dobby right now.
I'm impressed you were able to do that with the headset on. Like, kudos to you on that.
That's why it's angled down, actually, is because I couldn't hold it with the headset sitting right behind it, because otherwise it should actually be pointing out more straight.
Right.
Yeah, that's okay. I can be Dobby for a little bit.
Dobby was cool as far as I understand. I still have not watched the Harry Potters.
With the spirit gum, you can pull it off, and I will show you.
Oh no, are you really gonna do that? Oh, she did it.
I pulled it right off.
You did?
Yep. It's here. So you can see there's no buildup on the back, because these are good quality ears. Now, you do still want to clean the back of it, because there is still a little bit of spirit gum on here, and it is tacky. So you want to clean it if you want these to last long, because it will build up. And now I'm going to take a tissue, because, oh, that's tacky. And I felt it. It's in my sideburns. I felt it a little bit. Like spirit gum remover does not smell.
But it is odd, and it feels odd, and it's strange when you're trying to get
it's
it
very
out.
Very waxy. There. It's almost yeah. oily, because effectively that's what it is. It's an oil. Make sure to get the back of your ears. I feel like a mother telling her kid like to clean your behind your ears, but remember that you put spirit gum back there because you put it on the back of the ear. Hopefully, when you went to attach it, and sometimes people forget to clean the back of their ear when they go to take it off. So you just have to remember to get all of it off. Yeah. I didn't even put that much on there, I'll be honest. I would have put like more than I did because I didn't do the epoxy touch it and then take it off and then put it back on very well. That's what really makes it stick, actually. And it does take a pretty decent amount of this, actually. You've seen me, I've done this about 3 times now. It does take a decent amount to get it all off. It takes much less spirit gum to put it on than it takes spirit gum remover to get it off.
Yeah, and spirit gum, it's activated by the air. Once you use it, you take it out and you put it and apply it to your ear or to whatever prosthetics you have. That's when it immediately starts working and gets tacky, which is why it's always a good idea to dab it on your skin first, you know, let it get a little bit tacky, let it air so it gets some even more tackiness, and then you plop it down.
Speaking of airtight, when you store your ears, it is best to store them in a darkened area, so in a box, in a bag, whatever you prefer, but store it in an airtight place because over time this will break down faster and it will, the makeup will fade or it will discolor if it's under strong light all the time, and the air will cause it to degrade faster. So it's best if you can put it like in a Ziploc bag and then store it in a box. It'll last the longest that way. Not forever, but it will extend the life of your latex prosthetics. Trying to feel around and make sure that I got all of it. Yeah, I got all of it.
Anytime that I happen to do prosthetics or if I'm going like full sorry mode, like I just gotten into the habit of when I'm done with the costume, I'm taking a shower immediately afterwards. That way I clean myself completely of whatever adhesives may still be remaining.
Yes.
Kind of have to after a while because you just know you're going to miss something with that initial wash off. And you're like, yep, shower time.
Yes. And you don't see, but I'm cleaning the ears. The ear, singular. Because actually what ended up happening is that because there is some spirit gum left on this, the back flap and the front flap touched and they got stuck. And with latex, it can rip. If that happens, if you let it stay adhered. So again, this is why you clean them. And be gentle. You know, it's latex after all. It's not quite as durable as the human body. I have to clean the back flap too. Just like I cleaned the back of my ears, I have to clean the back of my ears. And basically, I just clean it until I can't feel the tack anymore. That's really all you need. You don't have to be perfect. There's no need. But that's basically it, unless anybody has any other questions.
Nope. The only other thing that we can say is that if you're having some trouble getting some of that spirit gum or even the prosate off, you can run your latex and the silicone through some cold water and just use some hand soap, mild hand soap, so that way it doesn't damage the latex or the silicone, and that'll help it remove the adhesive. You may have to like pick at it a little bit if it sticks on there too long, but that's another way to help remove it. I has much experience with this.
Elle actually has more experience with than I do.
Because I have done the full prosthetic Asari heads and I've done many bald caps. So after a while, you just kind of learn. Yes. You get the full mode when you go full on.
I stick with the ears because the ears are bad enough.
One day I would like to do a Klingon. It's going to be a nightmare, but it's going to be amazing.
Yep. So hopefully that was helpful for you guys. And I hope that you enjoyed seeing me go all Dobby on you live here for your entertainment and enjoyment. We at CosPod do seek to educate on what to do and not do by doing it in front of you.
That's how you learn.
Yes. And actually, I really do. I keep my ears in a Ziploc bag. And I keep them with their fellow chemicals, which helpfully enough, come wrapped in a little piece of butcher paper. And I just keep them together in my little cosplay box. That way it is kept away from light. And no, these chemicals are not as old as the ears. I have not kept these for 7 years. I trade out my Iridani stock every so often. It's really inexpensive to get a kit of the spirit gum and spirit gum remover.
Oh, yeah.
I say it's like $7 to get both.
If even that.
It's very reasonable, you guys. There we go. I am packing everything away.
She's so meticulous about this.
I have to keep it nice and neat because that's why they last so long. There. Plus, that way everything is nice and ready the next time I go to take it out and I don't have to worry about it. I actually have 2 bottles, one for each pair of ears, but I only have 1 canister of spirit gum remover. That way I don't contaminate. Cool. Well, I don't have anything else for this episode.
That's all I have. This was the whole shebang.
Awesome. Well, we will bring a close to this episode 187 of CosPod, the podcast for all things cosplay. If you guys enjoyed this, we highly encourage you to not only subscribe to the show, but we encourage you to share it with your friends. And of course, you can encourage them to find us on any of our social media, which of course you can find here.
While I'm doing this, I'm going to slowly slide this in. Oh, don't forget to enter our contest for this free book. Yay! Okay, back to Amber.
And of course, you can email us. You can email me how much you enjoyed my entertaining Dobby look at podcast@cospod.org. And of course, I will promptly tell you how much I enjoyed having spirit gum in my sideburns.
It's always an adventure.
It's definitely an adventure. We are willing to do it for you guys because we love you. But we hope that your cosplay is going better than my tutorial just did. And we hope that you are having fun at all of the various conventions that are going on around the world now and in the near future. We wish you guys happy cosplaying. Thank you for listening to the show. We'll see you next time in episode 188. Bye, everybody.
Bye, guys.